Every year, 900 million pounds of apples are produced here in Michigan. It's our single largest fruit crop, and we're the third largest producer in the United States. So it makes sense that our state flower would be the apple blossom. However, did you know it's specifically the crabapple blossom? We're going to get to the core reasons in this Michigan moment. Pyrus coronaria is the scientific genus of the flower that represents our state. But let's get one thing straight. Our state flower is a blossom. Yes, the blossom itself is a flower, but only blossoms form into fruit. To make it more confusing, blossom can be used as a verb meaning to grow, referring to flowering plants. To make it simple, all blossoms are flowers, but not all flowers are blossoms. The crabapple blossom is important to fruit agriculture everywhere apples are grown. The trees are planted amongst orchards with other apples to aid in the pollination process. You see, these blossoms give off a very potent honeysuckle scent that permeates through the orchards and makes all the blossoms more desirable to pollinators. Crab apples are also hardier fruits, and when crossbred with other apples over generations, can make fruit less susceptible to the cold. Very important to states like ours that can see late spring frost commonly. So where did it all start? Well, the decision to pick the apple blossom all started unofficially at the first Chicago World's Fair in 1893. At the exposition, a garland of flowers was hung, representing each of the then 44 states. Our flower was chosen to be the apple blossom. Michigan later made the decision official, making it our state flower in 1897. Now we're going to get a bit obscure because only 11 out of the 50 states have a state wildflower. Ours is the dwarf lake iris, which populates the shoreline of northern Lake Michigan and Huron. But why have you never seen one of these state flowers? Well, we're going to get to the root of it in this Michigan moment. Iris lacustris is its scientific name, and lacustris translates to of lakes, referring to its natural habitat along the high water lines of Michigan's lakes. The naturalist who first documented the flower was Thomas Nuttall, who found the species in 1810 on the island of Mackinac. Unfortunately, this plant has been losing its habitat, and back in 1988, it was put on the threatened species list in Michigan. The good news is many of the remaining colonies reside in state-owned parks, and the plant is said to be a resilient one, most being harmed by shoreline construction. The rare Michigan symbol can still be found in Alpena, Sheboygan, Chippewa, Delta, Emmett, Mackinac, Menominee, Schoolcraft, and Presque Isle counties. Additionally, many of our islands are home to the iris. Beaver, Drummond, Bois Blanc, Mackinac, and the Round Islands are prominent sighting locations. Look for these rare flowers blooming in mid-May and early June. This flower is endemic to the northern Great Lakes region, meaning it isn't found anywhere else. So if you see it, take a photo and refrain from plucking it, though they may be beautiful. You can also help the effort for preserving this one-of-a-kind state flower by growing your own from seed and educating others on this peculiarly petaled Michigan resident. Special thanks to USDA Forest Service for supplying the information for this episode, and you, the viewer, for spending a Michigan moment with us. If you would like to see something specific, leave a comment, and we'll see you next time on Michigan Moment.